now, a dude talking about film.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another broadcast of A Dude Talking About Film. Today, I am going to review Arrival. Arrival is a very, very good film, nominated for Best Motion Picture, also nominated for 7 other Oscar nominations, including Best Director Denis Villeneuve. It stars Amy Adams, Jeremy Renner, and Forest Whitaker. In short, and there'll be some spoiler alerts in this particular broadcast, the film was a interesting film for many reasons. Number one, it really messes with the whole linear sequence of time. So there is a lot of jumping around in this film. Amy Adams does an exceptional job. She is really, really quite convincing as a linguistics professor in this role. She is sort of the chosen one by these aliens, these 12 pods that come and land all throughout the world, and there is a lot of military response, and there's a bridge that needs to be created, and that's where Amy Adams comes in order to bridge the gap between the military and these aliens in communicating and finding out exactly why these aliens have come to Earth. So, in short, Amy Adams gets to the base in Wyoming, I believe, where there is contact being made, and her job is basically to use her linguistic skills to try to get a conversation going, a loop of communication. She does so meeting Jeremy Renner, who's also called to come and assist in communicating with these aliens to find out what their purpose is. Now, unlike other films in this particular genre, like War of the Worlds, etc., the confrontation and the military engagement is always looming as a threat, but the reason there is tension in the film is because Amy Adams' character, Dr. Louise Banks, is supposed to be able to solve the riddle of why they're here. And that is really the prevailing question that goes on throughout the film. Now, along the way, she is making headway with these aliens, along with Jeremy Renner's character, who is a physicist. And so throughout the film, Amy Adams' character starts to get more of an unpeeling or peeling of the onion as to what their purpose is here. And again, spoiler alerts, she starts to do things in order to create trust, and they will use their language to try and communicate with Amy Adams, and then she in turn does things to try to demonstrate her sincerity in wanting to understand why they're here. And once she does that, she is imparted by these aliens a special gift of being able, spoiler alert, to understand the non-linear progression and backward regression of time. So she, in essence, becomes a person gifted by the aliens who is able to understand time in a much different way. So that particular gift in and of itself is what prevents, and this is the real big climax of the film, she is able to prevent those military agencies that are representing the countries where these pods landed on from going all out ballistic on these alien pods, because they don't know why they're there. And so there's a lot of distrust. Some of the messages of the film, I think the big prevailing message of the film is, do you want to know what happens in the future? And if you did, would that change anything? So in the film, the notion of fatalism and the acceptance of what will unfold, your acceptance of what will unfold, knowing what will unfold, I think is the big question. And that's answered at the end of the film. I thought it was a great film. I'm not a big fan of this genre of filmmaking. I saw something posted on an internet periodical that said they predict that Arrival will not get any Oscar wins. It was nominated for 8, like I said, Oscar nominations. But I don't know. Was it a great film? Yes, it was a really, really good film. Was it a great film? I'm going to say borders on yes and just a little below great. Again, not my typical film that I really, really enjoy. I actually preferred Manchester by the Sea. I actually preferred Nocturnal Animals. But for this particular genre, it was very, very well done. And I think I would agree that I don't think it's going to take Best Picture. I don't think it's going to take Best Director. But it has some other sound editing and other nominations that it may gain some wins in. So, anyways, I am going to give Arrival a...
Awesome! Awesome! Awesome!
And there you go. Arrival, definitely worth seeing. Great performances by Amy Adams. Good performance by Jeremy Renner. It's good to see him. You know, Jeremy Renner, I have to say, and I've been meaning to say this as I was preparing for this review, I think Jeremy Renner's career, ever since The Hurt Locker, has sort of been more along the lines of him doing a lot of supporting roles and not that lead role that I thought he was going to establish as an A-lister when he did The Hurt Locker. I thought The Hurt Locker was an excellent film and he was fantastic. But he's very interesting as an actor in the choices that he makes. Amy Adams, I mean, what can you say about Amy Adams? I think Amy Adams is a hot commodity as an A-list actress. I think she is, we've yet to see the best of Amy Adams. Forest Whitaker, you know, he could play these kinds of roles. He plays a high-ranking military official. He could do these roles with his eyes closed. I would like to see him also do performances like in The Butler and films like The Butler. But overall, extremely well done, definitely worth seeing. All right, so Arrival, go watch it. This has been a dude talking about film.